Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting this video, we could expect to see another Starlink mission between now and the Falcon Heavy launch. The Starlink 431 mission is expected to lift off on Friday 28th at 12:30 a.m. UTC or Thursday 27th at 8:30 p.m. EDT. We'll take a look at the Falcon Heavy launch we can hopefully expect next week as there is an update. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Falcon Heavy USSF 44 is scheduled for Monday 31st at 1:44 p.m. UTC or 9:44 a.m. EDT. SpaceX posted this super cool picture of all 27 of Falcon Heavy's Merlin engines as they assembled the rocket in the hangar. Polaris posted a tweet about the Polaris Dawn mission. They said, "Today we announced the extensive suite of science and research experiments the Polaris Dawn crew will conduct throughout our mission." Polaris posted another tweet, but this one related to Starlink. They said, "We are excited to provide Starlink to over 100 schools in Chile and Brazil, and the Polaris Dawn crew recently talked to children at the first school in Chile to be connected as part of this effort." There's an article posted about a delay to the Polaris Dawn mission. It says, as recently as July, that mission was still scheduled to fly this year with a projected launch in December. By September though, the launch had quietly slipped to no earlier than March 2023, a date the Polaris program confirmed October 24th in an announcement of biomedical experiments it plans to perform on the 5-day flight. SpaceX posted a Starlink-related tweet saying, "Starlink is now available in Jamaica." Heading to Boca Chica, here's a cool view of the launch site with the active prototypes. Work has been going on with the suborbital Pad B test mount. The Booster 7 transport mount was moved back to the production site. There was recently a medevac helicopter seen at Starbase for some training. There was a Raptor engine that was seen moved to the launch site recently. The Starship 26 nose cone was seen moved back to the high bay. On Monday, SpaceX did full-stack cryogenic testing of Booster 7 and Ship 24. NSF posted this YouTube short of the test. Marcus House posted a tweet asking Musk still planning on B7 S24 being the first to launch? "Impressive seeing S25 looking so good already. It is truly astounding seeing S24, 25 and B7, 8 all at the launch site together." Musk responded and said, "That's the plan unless it is damaged in testing. What really matters is that ship and booster production line is spooling up. Also, each new ship and booster has incremental design improvements." Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, most dates remain the same. On Monday, SpaceX utilized the road closure for cryo testing of Booster 7 and Ship 24. Then the closure on Tuesday was cancelled. So, as of now, there are possible closures for today, Wednesday 26th, tomorrow, Thursday 27th, and Friday 28th. As of recording this video, the closure for today is already in place with the beach closed. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Plus, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content as well. Also, I have to say thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.